All right, welcome back to A Noob Plays NBA 2K18. I am SRD, and we will be taking on the Denver Nuggets in this game, so let's go. Oh my god, B is here. What are we doing?
Watch Shammy over here. Come on.
Oh yeah, watch me break it down.
No, I can't get that low. I can't let it get that low.
Can we send B out of this room? Embarrassing.
What's wrong? I don't see any hip movement. I don't see any passion out here. Except you, Shammy. You were beautiful. The rest of you, I don't have time for this.
Yo, my hips don't lie, man.
Hey, yo, watch me. Watch me.
You high. Shammy, head getting bigger by the minute, man.
That's great.
Because y'all can't dance.
You was killing it.
You got two left feet.
That's what I'm saying. Them ankles, man. They look slim. You know what I'm looking at? That's what I'm talking about.
Interconference matchup in today's game. Hi, everyone. We're happy to have you with us for this edition of the NBA.
We're at home at the Celtics Arena. Let's go and destroy the Nuggets. Kyrie hugging it out.
Kevin, growing up watching the game of basketball, who are some of your earliest
What am I looking at here, man?
My early influences in the game of basketball was Magic Johnson.
Sad sack looking coaches, man.
All
right.
Malik Sealy.
Starting center.
Generation of my inspiration. Yeah. St. John's was
That's my tip.
Michigan was one of my college destinations. So
look at that.
Those guys were my
national Oh, come on, guys. What the? Hey, you missed the layup.
Now let's take a look at Denver's opening lineup. Chandler at
Who am I covering? This big Slavic looking dude.
Will Barton is out there with Nelson.
Ooh, and it's three off the bat, man.
Kevin, one of the biggest moments of your career, the 2008 championship with
the
Boston Celtics.
Nuggets have got some bright uniforms.
You know, Kev, I can tell right away that we have something special getting together right in September, right before the year started. We started working out together. We started sharing concepts and how we saw the game.
Come on, Horford.
Right away, I could tell that the appetite was there. 1 through 15 guys, it's very rare that she was able to get that.
Ah, man, you got burned, buddy.
Soon as Danny, you know,
Millsap took you to school.
Just, you know, around each other, understanding each other, you know, playing a lot. We was playing a lot. Then, fortunately, we was able to go off to Rome that year.
Look out.
Rome was a good distraction. See ya. Because we had to lean
Give me my 2 points.
Bond a little bit. Seriously, because, you know, none of us spoke Italian. You know, if we wanted to go somewhere, we was always 3-4 deep. And no one was asking and no one was telling us to be with each other. We were just naturally being with each other so much that whenever you saw us to the restaurants, 9-10 of us, that carried over to practice. Then we got two teams that are very competitive. Doc was letting us be who we want to be, and he letting us play with passion, and our practices are over the top aggressive and to the point where it's too competitive to where he has to come
right,
in and separate
on,
us
Kyrie.
And, you know, take the balls and cut the lights out and get us out of here to the point where he just lets us go. Now we start bringing concepts to him. He started trusting our IQs. Now we start putting a couple things on defense. Thibodeau is in there. He's implementing stuff. I mean, this flow is going like this. You don't know you're going to win it all, but you know you're on the waves of something special. And that's how that felt.
And the steal then, right into the fast break, great awareness.
Yes, intercepted the ball in stride. Turnovers like this are devastating to the opposition.
Here we go.
Here we go. Irving's got it, the fast break chance, and the slam dunk by Irving.
Well, the quick hands of Irving to help create offense for himself on the other end.
And that replay presented by Under Armour showing us the fantastic steal that led to that fast break finish. Another unleash chaos moment. Kevin, you were always known as wanting to play and always wanting to practice. You're a gym rat. What did you do when a coach would ask you maybe to take a breather? Let's sit out this game. Let's rest up.
Give me that
board.
Welcome
that. Would you just say, I'll
Good
let
outlet
you
pass.
Go.
Go.
How would you
Come on.
That situation? You know
and
I've
one.
Asked
All
a
right.
Coach to respect the way
Give
I
me the assist.
I've always asked him to respect the way I approach the game. I've always asked the coach to respect
Let's go.
Me and my
We're up
expertise
five.
And knowing my body.
Maybe six.
I'm very, very vocal. Listen, one person needs rest. And it's me. I know how to raise my hand. I know how to say I need some rest. But, you know, I'm a person who likes to push through a lot of things. I'm a person who understands rest. Don't get me wrong. But at the same time, I'm a person who understands that practice makes perfect. And if I can work on something for as long as I can to make something better, because I know at the end when I need it, especially when I dial, I used to call it dial up. When I call, I need the answer.
And people may not know, KG, that you're not just a broadcaster for 2K, but you're a member of the 2K community.
Get out of here.
Shout out to all the 2K players out there. I'm Jizzle Lord, y'all know what it is. I'm Jizzle Lord.
All I need to do is slam it home.
Shout out to the team, y'all know what it is. Shout out to Deck, shout out to Bugs.
My picture. Where's SRD's picture, man? DJ.
It's all good. You know, I'm OBF. I'm about the team. I'm gang gang. You know what it is. Jizzle Lord, y'all holler at me. Y'all know what it is, 2K.
Jokic.
Right.
Jokic. Where's he from? Lithuania, Estonia.
Team. I didn't realize how much you love NBA 2K.
Oh, man, you know, 2K is always live, man. I'm a super fan. This game is going all over the place, bro. Like,
no,
seriously.
I
love
that.
Like,
oh, okay.
I'm geeked to see what's next, man. They got everything down. I'm sitting here watching all the little small intangibles that come with the game. I'm watching the game grow. I'm watching how better players
give you
are
a pick up here,
I'm
huh?
watching the online play, man. It's lit. It's lit. I can't wait to see this.
Oh, my. You got rejected, buddy. What was that?
His size, a pretty good rim protector.
Martin passes to Nelson. Kevin, we see some coaches get extremely emotional on the sideline. Others take a more even-keeled approach, more calm on the sideline. Which
get out of here.
Style would you
no, oh, come on, lucky crap.
You in your
what is that? Oh, yeah. You get like a freaking four bounces off the rim and it goes in.
I like the coach that was seven on the sideline. You know, I like to think that great coaches are going to be able to coach you in practice, and then during the games, you know, it's about the product and what you put out on the floor. You know, coaches that have understanding, coaches that have vision, coaches that understand the game, know, understand that it's a game of runs, know it's a game of momentum, and has plays for those momentums and those times. But the coaches I've always gravitated to.
So turn on? What happened?
Like Doc was kind of in between, when little bit
stepped
of emotion,
on line.
But he could also have a
stepped on line.
On that side.
Doc was on fire, I'm sorry. There was nothing calming about Doc.
All right, let's go. Come on.
Shout to Doc. Doc would rip your head off if you wasn't supposed to. But you know what?
I don't want
you
to get
play
there.
With that edge. You needed to
get
know
out of here.
He wasn't in your spot.
I was going to say, get out of here with that crap.
You understood that you were supposed to be there, and it's good to play with that. I think that you don't want to be out there playing like, you know, there's no big deal.
Right, excessive call for pass deal. My ass.
No play, you
I was
know,
open.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And you know what?
Why shouldn't I call
that
for
severity,
it?
And you play with that importance. And, you know, we're going. We're going. Guy, so, you know, that's important.
And KG, you're retired from the game now, and you're stepping into the broadcast business a little bit. Now,
traveling violation. I forced the turnover there. Had him worried. Took too many steps.
I'm having a great time watching the games. It's really cool being a fan now. I can root for people I want to root for.
Get out of the way. Monster dunk going down.
And I'm getting the tee, so, you know,
and who is this guy talking, man? Is that KG again?
You know, it's not just you going there and you have a bunch of fun. You know, we actually get some things done.
I knocked the ball loose. Oh, now we got a jump ball. Guess he's going to win this.
You know,
ooh, they get a little testy.
Man, great, rest in peace to Craig, you know, Ernie, all of Charles.
Come on, Horford, you better out and jump that guy.
Has definitely helped. Not
just
me,
didn't.
But our younger generations of broadcasters. Man, totally. I didn't see this being my lane, but I'm having fun.
Get
right
out of here.
You're doing a great job. And KG,
defensive breakdown. It wasn't even my guy, I don't think.
You don't age. You cool. Do not. You.
Man,
you
listen,
do not
listen,
age.
Man, listen, I wish I could use the Beyonce. I woke up like this. But actually, I woke up like this and worked out some more and then worked out a little more to look like this.
You look and one.
Man, what's your secrets, man?
I'm following you, watching
yeah,
your
right,
advice.
Yeah,
come on,
yeah,
Jokic.
Man,
is that him?
Yeah,
I didn't know that's
for you, seriously. Broadcasting
the NBA.
All right.
20 years and then 12 years with 2K.
Man, you're a beast, man. You know what I love about 2K, man? They bring the best in.
All right, let's go.
You understand?
We're up by eight.
Well, that's why we've got you. But, Kevin, you play this game a lot, don't
man,
you? Especially when you were younger.
Man, listen, man. 2K is it, bro. Hey, there's no other
all right.
games out
beautiful.
Here. This is what it
beautiful,
is.
Man.
You play basketball, if you online, nobody's playing nothing else. This is it.
Oh, my God.
2K is the cream of the crop. It's the gang gang. They know what it is. It's lit. They know what it is. Seriously.
I don't think I
want to
leave my...
Kevin, when you entered the draft, no player had made the jump from high school to the NBA in 20 years. And what were your emotions when your name was called number 5 overall?
Oh, man. I remember that. It was
17 years old.
17, just turning 18 at the time.
All right.
It was in like a whirlwind, to be honest.
Points are just
coming. People don't know, it's a lot of stuff that goes up into the draft. You know, things that I wasn't aware of. You're training twice a day. You know, you're trying to get ready for the combine. You're trying to get ready for pre-draft.
Yeah, you're down by 11. You better take care.
This is all new to me. On top of still going to high school, trying to, you know, graduate and stuff. So I figured it out. I hustled and I bustled and I juggled a bunch of different things. But once your name is called, it's almost like the culmination.
Wait, I think I ever shut up.
It's a special moment for just you and your family and your loved ones and ones around you. And when my name was called, it felt like the world had stopped and everything was going very slow.
And KG, when you were bringing those greats together like you had in Boston, the intersection of you and Doc and Paul Pierce and Ray Allen, all these guys together, everything was aligned.
But you know, you got to go through something to be able to appreciate something. Mm-hmm. And I like to think that with the joining of myself and Ray Allen and Paul Pierce going to Boston, that we all had to have a journey up
all
to
right.
that point and go through Shammy. Something, and feel something, have something, feel left out. We all was achieved when we all came together. Awards, countless all-star achievements. But then,
yeah, no doubt. I mean, a testament to how level-headed this group is. Nice job.
Let's go, Shammy.
Executing on the offensive
Let's
end.
Put on a show.
Kevin, of all the people you've faced, who is the toughest guy for you to score against?
That's not putting on a show. What in the hell is going on?
Who is the toughest to score against down there?
Listen, I know a lot of people. I've always said Rasheed Wallace. I've always said Tim Duncan. They're probably the two that brought a different level of play out of me.
But okay, we're playing trash ball
Cliff
right
Robinson,
now.
Man. Cliff Robinson, I don't know if people know this, but
Robinson.
Cliff Robinson, man. Cliff Robinson was one of the better defenders in the post. He was very strong. He was very long. He didn't go for any counters. He was
Did
very disciplined.
He
was well prepared because he was a veteran. The refs let him get away with a lot, touching and grabbing. He knew when to be physical in some positions. He knew to do
right.
what we call work early. He would meet
Got
you.
Got the assist.
The people line, and he would be fighting you, and you would post up probably like a step outside the people line. Like he was really good at some of his techniques and how he was able to control the post. After Cliff left the game, I watched
this guy
just
camping. Just camping underneath there.
I had to because it was so effective against me that I was able to use the other post players on the defense.
Oh, you gotta be!
Dennis Rodman was another guy.
What
a lot
the
I watched
frick?
A lot. Akeem Olajuwon, I watched a lot.
What type of lucky bounce is that, man? Where do they get those bounces?
Similar to my makeup. Akeem Olajuwon was long.
All right, let's take a rest, man. Minute left in the quarter. All right.
Coming out of high school, you were relatively mature.
Okay, we are
17, turning 18.
Easily
do
ahead.
You ever regret not trying?
I'm back on Jokic.
Seeing what that experience would have been like. I mean, it's such a long time ago, but you've had some chance probably to get some perspective on both sides of that story.
You know what, Kev? I look at it like the unknown is the unknown. Obviously, mm-hmm. I've had friends mm-hmm. that went to college. Some of my best friends went to college, and I think I've kind of lived it through them a little bit. Listen, when you have responsibility
right.
early in life.
Which you did.
Which I did.
Yes.
And, you know, so from a mature level, things that interest me are not that interesting as you get older, especially when you have to deal with a vigorous schedule of an NBA schedule. I wasn't
We're moving that ball around.
The 17, 18-year-old to chill. Have,
keeping
you know,
them off balance.
A little bit, be able to be at home. You know, coming home through the weekends. No, I had a real life that I was responsible for. And
oh my God,
I was
really?
Something. I was building something. You know, I was
Let's
trying
see,
to
man.
Making
that
just be
freaking
a young player. No
way you're making that
a
shot.
Businessman, want to establish something for myself, my friends, my family.
Get down there. Get down there.
Thinking like
Come
a
on. Oh my God, guys.
You're taking pieces from grown men.
Block the lanes.
All the time you're around. People who need something all the time. At some point, you have to put all this together, and you have to make
See
it work for you. And you have to put your spin on
Can't
it.
Can't stop me in the baseline.
Your brand, and you have to be innovative with that. You have to be creative with that. You have to have a vision.
Wow, yeah, there's a lot to consider. We've got Irving. Horford is out there with the monster, and it's Hayward, and it's Abrines in at the two guard. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the monster in the last game against the Bulls was huge. He ended up with 19 points, and in addition to his scoring, he also finished with a season high in rebounds. He racked up big numbers in what was a really good performance.
Oh, bullshit.
Can he carry it over tonight? We'll see, Kevin.
Thanks, David. It was a performance.
No, I'm not having
not
the boards
tonight,
man. I
got to
play outside more, man.
Forget it.
You guys are dragging me out. Oh, crap.
here tonight. When you're that hot, it takes a while to cool down.
I think that's the kind of game that carries over, and he'll have every chance to do it because I've got to believe
I wasn't planning on shooting there.
The Nuggets trail by 13. Well, the fans out there watching this, Kev, can you talk about why it's so incredibly difficult to win an NBA title, to become a champion? Why is it such a tough process?
Well, just imagine having a goal and you're not pursuing the goal by yourself. You know, say you and somebody else.
Relying on somebody else.
Yes. Okay. So let's just say you and someone are doing something to walk in
the I hit the shot button, man. Not the freaking pass.
Well, the speed at which you want to walk at might be different from the other person. And what you realize about when you're trying to reach any goal is that you have to be connected. You have to be understanding of, we're going to walk up here together like at this speed, like this, or we're going fast, we're going slow. It has to be a great level of communication and understanding. At the same time, you have to have the same work because you have to understand you're together.
All right.
And you don't get to go at this level and leave someone behind. You have to actually, you got to pull them, you got to keep up, whatever it is. All this goes into trying to win.
It sure does. That's right.
Yeah, I mean, the way he's climbing
first foul.
All over him on that one, no way the officials are going to miss that.
I think you can't even go for that rebound. He's completely
oh, shut the hell up.
Out. Just leave
what do you
alone.
Know? Quit criticizing.
Hernan Gomez. He feeds it to Barton. Chandler against Hayward. Chandler, the pass to Jokic. Lock at six. Martin from outside drills the three-pointer.
What the freak, man?
Got himself going with the triple, his first
man,
basket
I'm
of the game.
Man, I'm a nasty dude today.
Well, he works to find the
everything's
open space
irritating
behind
me.
The arc, and it pays off with the three. Nice.
Down low. Outside Irving. In the corner, Horford with it. Over Hernan Gomez. Score
all
the
right.
Basket, his third after five shots.
Good turnaround.
Really
a little bit like Elvin Hayes
the
there.
Quarter after missing everything in the first.
It's Barton on the wing.
God, who remembers Elvin Hayes, man?
Chandler is screen.
Gotta be old to remember Elvin Hayes.
He's picked up by Irving.
Play for the Bullets.
Chandler, no good.
Thank you, Hayward.
He's
got position on me.
Convert.
I think, Greg, that's exactly what you want. The screen was solid. The execution
let's
is
go.
A little bit short on the shot.
Adding a lot of flavor to the mix, Kevin Garnett. Kevin, thanks for stopping by. Always a pleasure. Hope you join us again sometime.
Man, Kevin, it's always a pleasure, man. It's always great to see you, man. Anytime you need me, holler at me, all right?
Future Hall of Famer and a terrific person, Kevin Garnett. And, Doris, one of the things that really strikes me about KG, he's as smart as he is athletically gifted. What a treat to have him join us tonight.
Well, I'm in awe of his enthusiasm. And it's not just when he's talking, but when others are talking as well. There's so much life to the conversation. Everything he brought to the court for 21 years, he now brings to the booth.
Yeah, he doesn't stop talking about it.
Barton against Hayward. And the whistle blows, so a chance here for a three-point play.
Yeah. I didn't see the foul there.
In the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Boston making some changes. Morris is checked in for Horford. Jaylen Brown comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Wells is subbed in for Alex Abrines. Big group substitution here for Denver. Fareed's checked in for Hernan Gomez. Millsap comes in for Wilson Chandler.
Shimmy.
Maurice checked in for Barton. And Emmanuel Mudiay subbed in for Jameer Nelson. Mudiay kicks to Jokic. And it's blocked by Brown, and he's able to get it back. That's it, and the Celtic lead is cut down to just 8 points with the bucket from Millsap. Irving. And so it's the Boston Celtics in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They're
my halftime stats, what are they? 15 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. Eh. I don't want anyone about the road. Okay, yeah, that's sad news here.
Now the third
sad sack news. Let's go.
You know, Paul Millsap,
don't be a sad sack, coach.
It's been
nobody's worried about the refs. I'm not worried about him.
From a defensive standpoint, a lot of shots also being blocked.
Come on, Jokic.
Well, he has been in the grill of his man all night. He's used his reach to turn away those shots. You have to love the defensive effort.
Second half underway. Here's who Mike Malone's got on the floor. Down low, it's Millsap and Jokic. Nelson is out there with Will Barton, and it's Chandler in at the three spot. Doris, so often we talk about high basketball IQ. Is that something you can learn, or do you have to be born with something like that?
I think it's probably a little bit of both, but if you look at someone like LeBron James, whose basketball IQ may be the highest we've ever seen, I think he's
beautiful move.
Basketball knowledge is always expanding, and I think if you love the game, you're constantly taking in information, so probably a little bit of both.
So you've always got to be curious, right? Even if you're at the top of the game like LeBron or yourself.
Right. LeBron is just
another rebound. What do they call that? A steal. Okay.
His ante in terms of film watching,
I don't know how that's a steal.
Really special to be able to watch that guy work.
I know that's how you prepare as a broadcaster now. I'd like to tag along sometime and watch you prepare for a game. That'd be a lot of fun.
Look, man, I give you a shot. You take it. Make it. Come on, get him, Jokic. Get him, Jokic.
Nelson kicks to Jokic.
Where you going? Where you going? Where you going? Where you going? Oh, hell no.
No good.
Give me that. What are you trying to pull with that turnaround from way out there?
He feels like he's good enough to be the man on a team that can contend
for a championship.
And you might question how he went about it, but he's basically been a pro in his approach, and he's got the chance.
Rebounds are coming now. Starting to wear these guys down.
Here at the start of the second half, that's their third straight miss.
Oh, come on with this layup miss.
Boy, that's high impact
recent
defense
foul
in the lane. Standing tall.
Third foul of the game.
The easy bucket.
Trying to be aggressive, trying to get the ball, make things happen.
Last game for the Celtics, they pick up the win against the Bulls in Chicago.
And when you shoot a high percentage from distance, that gives you momentum.
Get him,
and
get him,
really
get him.
Keeps the opponent on the ropes.
The other thing it does, Greg, it opens up the floor, right? The other team had zero answer for their outside shooting in that one.
Martin passes to Jokic. Millsap kicks to Nelson.
Boy, they can't buy one right now. 0 for 4 to start the second half.
Nelson with another miss. Pass to Smart. Horford has a wide open look. His three-pointer's off the mark.
And he's wide off the mark.
12. Barton, wide open. He fires. Here's Jokic. And good work on the boards. They pick up the
I'm
second
surprised they didn't
points.
Hit me for defensive breakdown
Jokic
there.
Jokic has got 9.
By 10, let's go. Just such a crucial part of the game.
I'll tell you, if you don't box out well, expect to get burned.
Come on.
Give them second chance opportunities.
How am I missing those, man? My touch is
Chandler kicks to Nelson.
Hit and miss.
Pass to Jokic. Let it go with a three. The basket.
Oh, for Christ's sake, man.
From Nelson.
What's that voodoo?
Back down to within single digits for the Nuggets. For Boston, they've gone 2 of 6 from the field here in the third. Now here's Smart defending.
Take the shot.
And here's Smart. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. For three, Hayward. The monster passes to Hayward. A second chance effort. He lays
all right.
Up. He's got 5.
Make no mistake,
give me the assist.
Hayward,
thank you.
Finisher near the bucket. He'll take what the defense
gives. Make the double double.
Jokic just screen. Nelson kicks to Barton. Goes up off the pick. No stopping.
Not on me. Jams it say, that ain't my foul. Why would you foul that guy? You know he's gonna dunk it, man.
It's gonna go on Gordon Hayward and the Nuggets making a change here.
Oh, come on.
Well, the
defensive breakdown.
A much more significant piece of the Celtics offense. They went from middle of the pack to top three in makes from deep last year.
Shit, man. I'm breaking to the basket and you don't freaking pass it to me.
Smart dishes to Hayward. The pass to the monster. Barton with some nice D.
All right.
And for the Celtics last season, their three-point attempts up by almost a third. At the same time, improved their percentage.
Well, this is an organization that reflects the way the league is going. They are especially dead for
let's
the
go, guys. Let's go.
Threes, and that really elevated their offense.
Smart passes to the monster. Feeds it to Smart. Called in by the Nuggets. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of Boston.
Yeah, should be an interesting matchup tonight. These two teams will only
why did you foul that guy going in, man? Come on.
Here's Moutier looking for his first basket still in this one. He dishes it to Millsap. Puts it up from 15. Offensive rebound. And the foul called on Marcus Morris. That's foul number two for him. Full 24-second shot clock. And so here's Denver, trailing by five. Now here's Murray. Not a lot of room. Millsap in the corner.
Well, he had the defense's attention, dropping two threes in the first half, but he hasn't made one since.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Here's the monster.
Nothing's going, man. Cole is ace.
Fareed's got three rebounds so far in the game.
He's trying to make something happen, but obviously it's been a tough quarter.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge.
Come on, Shammy. Damn it.
Emmanuel Moutier spent a year in China prior to the NBA rather than playing in college. People respect what he did while he was over there. He said,
let's go, boys.
In a foreign country, everything is different. It made me mentally strong. Now in the NBA, he said, you've got to have confidence because every point guard in this league can play. You got to keep that edge and be prepared at all times. Kevin?
Thanks, David.
Get out of here.
Attitude is critical, especially when you're a young player in this league.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path to the bucket.
That is how it is done.
Great teamwork. That's something you develop by practicing it over and over again.
There you go. There you go.
Murray.
Didn't think so. Get out of here. Get out of my area. Millsap.
Down to five on the shot clock. Double team on Millsap.
Oh, no.
Clean look. That one doesn't drop. Now Boston takes it the other way. Looking ahead,
they've
got
there.
The Jazz coming into town for the next game. That'll be the latter half of this two-game homestand. Down kicks to Morris. Here's Rozier. Inside. Here's the monster. A shot.
Oh, come on.
Good.
What the
Some
frick, man?
Defense from Fareed.
I'm right there into the basket.
Moutier with the ball. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Now the dish to Fareed. Now here's Murray. Defense is right there. No good on the shot.
Boy, too much traffic in the lane. Very difficult finish with the defense draped all over him.
Celtics passing it around. Takes a three. Wells' shot is good.
All right, Shammy. There you go.
Wells has got 9 points.
Back up to seven.
Wells has such a quick release. He's ready to pull as soon as the ball hits his hand.
1:11 left in the third. Deflects the
steal.
Bounds then up to hand. Well, you look at the monster. While not in the top five currently, he's definitely on the radar screen, and he's been playing some very solid basketball.
And it's been quite a rookie season for this group. Amazing how well they've adapted to the professional game.
Boy, it really is. There have been very few growing pains for this group, and it's no small sample size we've seen.
Let's go. Oh, come on.
These are bona fide NBA players now.
Outside Millsap, screened by Fareed, to the left side wing. Now here's Murray. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. For three, Nelson, and Boston with the rebound. Morris has got three rebounds so far in the game.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes. Shot.
Here's Abrines. He's covered by Murray. The kick out to Brown.
And one. Yeah.
Triple.
Three.
Well, to me, that's excellent timing
not
for Jaylen
one.
Brown. He shoots with confidence.
All right. That's the end of the third.
And so it's the Boston Celtics with a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break.
Let's go.
They played the better game so far, but their work is far from over. We
far
come back
over.
Right after this. Mike Malone moments ago with some words for his player.
And we don't care.
Don't get down.
We'll get down, you're losing. All right, I'm out. When do I come in? 6:33 left.
Monsters checked in for Morris.
We're up by 11.
Comes in for Jaylen Brown. And Smart subbed in for Alex Abrines. Denver also making some changes. Trey Lyles checked in for Jokic. And Barton subbed in for Jameer Nelson.
Shooting?
Hayward out there with Horford. And there's the monster. And it's Kyrie Irving.
Nope.
And it's Smart in at the two spot. That's the penalty. Boston Five. Well, we all have hobbies outside basketball, Doris. You've said
right,
that one of your passions is cooking. And I know this personally. I have to ask, what's your best dish? What's your specialty?
You know, that might be too many to name, but if I were to pick just one, I would probably have to say my chicken tettuccine is my children's favorite. Boy, I can throw down in the kitchen, Kevin.
Learn that from Mom? Did you just pick that up on your own? How'd you learn to be such a good cook?
You know, my daughter and I, that was one thing that sort of really bonded
us.
We would watch a little cooking show on TV, head to the kitchen, and try to reproduce it. So Sarah and I did some work.
Love that story.
Boy, you know, a lack of effort defensively, and he gets a very good look from deep.
Here's the monster. He kicks it to Hayward. Over Millsap. And that one hits back iron.
Boy, what a tough night. Imagine what their lead would be if he were having a better night from the field.
Right wing. Here's Fareed. And it's Kyrie Irving with the rebound. Boston leading by nine. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. Millsap's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Got it. Good job in the low post.
Man, good shot, man. He was well contended there.
And Millsap just feeling it. Doesn't take much to get him going.
Here's the monster. Some solid defense from
that was definitely a bad shot, Zalek.
Or what? But he is definitely holding back a little bit, and he has to step his game up right now.
Thank you.
Now Murray. It's Barton on the wing. Lyles kicks to Murray.
He was wide open there. Wide and took
the
shot.
Right wing. Over Hayward.
Give me that.
One goes long.
Just a little hesitation on that release, right? His timing looked a bit off.
To the paint. Here's the monster.
Good. All right, got one to go, man. Thank you, Kyrie, for the dish.
He's got such soft touch around the rim. The D has to try to keep him out of the paint, because if he gets close, it's lights out.
This is it to Lyles. There's the feed to Murray. Dishes it to Millsap. Inside, Lyles. Nice fake, but the layup off the mark.
Boy, a kickout's probably a better option when the defense is swarming around like that.
Nice shot by Smart.
Well, this is what you hope for from your franchise guy. Total unselfishness. Gordon Hayward with a pretty look.
Fareed, left side. Over Horford. And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
Well, that's just taking your eyes off the target before releasing the pass. Very careless.
All right, we got three and a half left.
Chandler comes in for Fareed, and Nelson is subbed in for Jamal Murray. Boston leading by 11. And here is Irving. Smart with the ball. In the corner, Horford with it. The kick out to Irving. Over Nelson. And it's Boston with another.
He's taking
right.
a lot of pressure off the other players right now with how well he's shooting it.
The Nuggets trail by 13. He feeds it to Barton. Pass to Lyles. Millsap a screen. Barton kicks to Chandler. The Nuggets with another miss.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's the teardrop.
Oh.
Irving can't hit. Denver's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. In the corner, it's Nelson. Pass to Millsap. And Millsap snaps it in.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
Boston leading by 11. Smart dishes to Irving. Here's the monster.
Relentless.
Just
got to make the shots.
Got three
rebounds. You're being relentless. Field goal percentage is
Nelson
shit.
Outside, the pass to Lyles. Barton kicks to Millsap. And it's sent back by Horford.
Well, how about the anticipation from Al Horford? Perfectly times the release, sends it back.
They've been doing a great job of sharing the ball.
And guys, shot A comes to mind for me because right now that offense, it's a smooth.
Oh my God, I can't hit a damn thing.
The Nuggets trail by 11. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
1:44 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Irving kicks to Horford. Passes it to the monster. Feeds it to Irving. Hayward passes to the monster. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. 24 points for the monster.
And some guys just have a nose for scoring. And this one couldn't have been any easier.
Well, really good awareness by the scorer. You're seeing an opening in the defense and exploiting it beautifully.
Here's Millsap. But they recover it. Chandler.
Loud offense. Come on, man. That thing was like shot outside. Bad block attempt.
And a foul on Marcus Smart. That'll be his second foul of the game. Kenneth Faried's checked in for Wiles. Here's Barton. Chandler, the pass to Nelson. Back to Chandler. Six to shoot. Barton outside. Off target with his three. They're this close to putting it away.
Yeah, they don't need to do anything special. Just take time off the clock.
In the corner, Smart with it. Pass to the monster. And the foul on the monster. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
He's up, coach.
Group out on the floor for the Celtics.
Taking me out? Because I got four fouls? Yeah, that's probably, that's the game anyway. All right, coach is irritated with me, but c'est la vie. We got another W.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here.
Can't complain. All right, let's see how we did. Four dunks. Post-spin finishes. 17 rebounds. So I tried to get to 20 and 20. I didn't make it, though. Blocks. One block, two hard hits. Eight good screens. Glad they appreciate that. 2 for 3 from the line. 50-50 plays, 180. Fixed dodge, runners and floaters, tireless shots, assist 4, what an opponent plays, strong finishes 6, win bonus 675. All right. Moving on up. Increase that fans, man. Let's go. All right. Over 170,000. We're getting up there. We're getting up there. So, yeah. 24 points, 4 assists, 17 boards.
The guys back in the studio want to do an interview with you.
They want to do an interview with me again? All right. Aight. What's up?
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Let's go. Come on.
Hey,
what do you got?
Welcome back to the studio here on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith in a moment to speak with our post-game guest who's standing by on headset near the locker rooms.
Hey, it's Kenny. You were just lighting it up on the offensive end. Were you looking for your shot out there or just playing within the offense?
Well, I feel like I just happen to be in the right place at the right time in a lot of our offensive sets. You know, our offense does a good job of creating looks for everyone on the floor, and you know, I was just lucky enough to find open space more often than not, Kenny.
Well, good job. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
All right. Nice and sweet. Short and
sweet. And that's going to do it for tonight.
All right. That is going to do it for the night. Let's we got any other cutscenes here? Doesn't look like it. All right, well, that is going to be it for this time. We'll catch you next time on A Noob Plays NBA 2K18. Thanks. Bye.